Hello everyone and welcome to this channel. In this video, I will show you how to easily download and install PyCharm version 2020.3 on Windows 10, which was recently released by JetBrains. You will also be able to run your first command or program in PyCharm IDE. For those not familiar with PyCharm, PyCharm is an integrated development environment used for computer programming, especially for the Python language. It provides you with all the tools you need for productive back-end and front-end Python development and integration with other applications. There are other IDEs, such as the one provided by Microsoft Visual Studio or Spyder Anaconda, and even Python itself has its own IDLE. I have tried some of these IDEs. In my opinion, I seem to prefer PyCharm because of the flexibility it offers in terms of Python development. One thing to note here, since PyCharm IDE relies on Python language to run its scripts, it is essential that you have any version of Python installed on your computer before installing PyCharm and running your first program. To begin, I will quickly show you how to install Python, and we will move on to install PyCharm version 2020.3 on Windows 10. I have also provided a link of my previous video on how to download and install Python 3.9.1 and other useful links in the description below this video. Let's jump into this right away. So let's start with the Python installation. So you open your browser and then you type Python and then you go to this Python official website. You click on it and then here you have the current version of Python, which is Python 3.9.1. Or you could also go to this window here and you will see older versions of Python. So you can select any version that suits you and you can install that. So for today, I'm going to install Python 3.9.1. So I just select the download. Once the download is completed, I open this file and then I select add Python 3.9 to path. I check this box and then I go to customize installation and I go to next. And I select install for all user and I go to install. Once I'm happy with where the destination is, I select install. Once this is complete, I close this and then I quickly check if my Python was installed successfully and if I can now run my first program with Python. So you see here the Python was successfully installed and this is the Python IDLE. I can open the Python IDLE. And here I can run my first program in Python. Say print hello world. And this is my first official program in Python within Python IDLE. So next we go to install the PyCharm IDE. Let me close this. So to install the PyCharm version 2020 IDE, you type in your PyCharm and then you come here, the official PyCharm website, which is developed by JetBrains. You select this, and once this window opens up, this is the current version that we are trying to install, which is version 2020.3, which was released on the 2nd of December 2020. If you need to check your system requirement, if it meets the specification, you could select on the system's requirement, and once you're happy with this, you can close this. And here you see that PyCharm allows you to install this IDLE in Windows, in Mac, or in Linux. Here you have two types of PyCharm. So you have the professional and the community. The professional has some added features into it, and you need to pay for this after using its free trial. While the community version is free. So if you want to see the difference between the professional and the community, you can go to features here And then once we scroll down, you see the added features to the professional edition and the community edition. And you could give a try to the professional edition by selecting the download here, or you could use the community one. In my opinion, if you are just using it for personal use, I would say you go with the community version. You should be able to do most of the things you would want to do using the community version. Personally, I use the community version. But if you are working on complex projects that requires access to other database or SQL support, or you're working on a web development project, or you need other complicated functionalities, then you can go for the professional edition. But for beginners, I will recommend you start with the community edition. So for this tutorial, I will go with the community edition. So I come here and I select download. And then here, if you want to subscribe, you can enter your emails and enter your details, else we wait for the download to be completed. You see the size of the file is 349 megabytes. Once your download is complete, we again open this file here, and then we select next. And then here we specify the destination of this PyCharm that we are installing. If you're happy with your destination, you can click next. If you're not happy with destination, you could go on browse to select your destination. I'm happy with the destination. So you select next, and then here you select the bit launcher. So once you finish installing, you will see this on your desktop. So I will select the bit launcher to appear on my desktop. And then here you can select the path, so this your computer can recognize this. But the caveat here is, once you do check this box, you will need to restart your computer. So I will check this box. And then here I want to add this open folder as project, and I want to also create association. So I will check this box. And once you are happy with the boxes, you can select next. And here you can install. So it's now installing. Once your installation is complete, you can either reboot the system now, or you could do that manually. So I will go with doing it manually later. So I'll just leave this box here, check, and then I select finish. And then we'll go check on our desktop for the PyCharm launcher. I'll just minimize this. So here you can see that our PyCharm Community Edition was successfully installed. Next, I can right click to open this. And you can now see the PyCharm Community 2020.3 is opening. So this is the welcome page of the PyCharm 2020.3 edition, which is quite different from its previous version. So right now you now have project here, customize here, plugins, learn PyCharm. So if you want to customize, you need to come here, customize. Here you can change the theme color. You could either use Dracula or whichever color that suits you. So here I'm going to use this first one. And here again, you could edit the IDE font and the editor font. So you could select that and you could make that adjustment. Once you're happy with your adjustment, here you could come to plugins to add other plugins that you feel will be useful for you, like the CSV plugin and like the IDVim if you're familiar with that, and other plugins that you feel are necessary for your work. You could install those plugins in here. And then here, if you want to learn PyCharm, it's going to give you access to some resource on how to program with PyCharm. In this environment, you have my previous PyCharm model that I've developed. So I could select any of these if I want to launch into them directly. Then here, it gives me access to previous versions of models that I've developed. So if I select on these, I could come here. If I have my previous versions in any particular repository, I could enter the URL, or if I have the GitHub account, I could select this to access my account. S, I just close this. And then here you could select a new project if you want to start up a new project. Here you can open your project that is saved within your system, and then you could select any of those and I cancel this. So here is to start up a new project. So I'll just quickly go to start a new project. And once I have my new project wizard opened, here I can now give a name to the project. Let's say I call it Python Tests. Then here you can select the environment that you want to use for your modeling, whether Conda or Py environment or your virtual environment. So I'll just leave it at virtual environment. And then here is the location of your file. So you could again change the location if you want. You could go in and select different locations that you want. I just cancel this. And then here you have the base interpreter. If you have other versions of Python, you could select what particular interpreter you want to use for your new project. So you could either use Python 2.7 or any version that you have already installed in your system. So for this, I will just go with my current version of Python that I installed, which is 3.9. So this is why you need to have your Python installed before installing PyCharm, because PyCharm will depend on this Python language to run any script that you're writing. So I just select my latest version of the Python that I've installed, which is 3.9. And here you can check this inherit global site packages for some of the functionalities you have in this model to be accessible to other models. So I'll just check this. And then the same thing with make available to all project, I will just check this. And then here again, it says if you want your previous configured interpreter, you could select this. If you want your previous interpreter, and you can select any of the previous interpreter and all that. But for this, I want to use this new virtual environment, and I want to use my current interpreter that I have installed, which is 3.9. The next, you select create, and is now creating a virtual environment for you to start your PyCharm programming. So I'll just maximize this page. And here you have different tabs for different functionalities in PyCharm, which I will explain in my next video. Here you have some shortcut keys which you could use to access your files. So go to File, Control, Shift, N. And then here you have your projects. So for this project that we are starting, which we've called Python Test, so this is a project folder. Within this project folder, you could have other folders inside of it or other files inside of a project and other functionalities associated with that project. So if I click on this drop-down menu, I will see some other folders that are associated with this Python test file that was created when I initiated a new project. And here I have other external libraries that are associated with the project that I have created. So next, we could either come here to right click and then select new, and then we go to Python file. There are other files that you can create here, but for the purpose of this model, we want to create a Python file. So I will select Python file, and then this new Python file window comes up here for me to enter the name of the Python file. So let's call this first Python or first model. And then here we select the Python file. So this is our Python file that has been created. Next, we go straight to write our first Python model. So I could say here, print hello world. And then I could go down here to say a equals 2 plus 4, and I could say C equals A minus 3. So once you're okay with your first model you have created, next is to run the model. There are four ways to run this model. You could either come here, select run, and then you run, or you come here, right click on the first model here, and then you select run. The third option is to come here and click run. And the fourth option is to use the shortcut key Shift plus F10. So let's try one of them. Let's do this one, run. And then here is prompting me that which model do I want to run, or do I want to still edit the configuration? That means I need to edit my interpreter, or I just want to run my model. So I want to run the model. And you can see here the model has finished running. And you can ask, why is my A and C not appearing here? Because I didn't add the print function. So if I decide to go here and say print A, and then I go here and say print C, and then I can rerun. So I will now use this other option to run. I'm running now. You can now see my A is 7 and my C is 4. So in this video, I've been able to show you how to download and install PyCharm version 2020.3 on Windows 10 and also showed you how to install your Python and run your first program using PyCharm IDE. I hope you find this video useful and you now know how to download and install PyCharm on your Windows 10 computer. If this video was useful, please hit the like button and subscribe. Also, hit the notification icon so you'll be notified on my next weekly video. And if you have any difficulty downloading or installing the PyCharm version 2020.3 on your Windows 10 computer, please leave a comment in the comment section below this video, and I'll be happy to support in any way that I can. Thank you for watching and see you in my next video. Bye for now.